Selling as we know it has shifted. Before, salespeople armed with a territory, price structure, and targets could roam so long as they managed their territory and produced results. Sales management provided oversight, bridged with corporate, and could be hands-off. Not today. A study by Docurated found that only one-third of a sales rep's day is actually spent selling, while another third of their time is spent searching for or creating content. 25% goes to reporting, administrative, and CRM-related tasks. 82% of sales reps feel challenged by the amount of data and the time it takes to research a prospect. Sellers today are different, and managers need to adapt. Think of territories, customers, and products as if they were a financial portfolio that you've invested in. Since your salespeople are part of that investment, you have to own their calendar, workflow, and time management. This is not micromanagement because the rep doesn't own the investment. The company does. So, these are your new 7 responsibilities. 1. Selecting targets. Salespeople are capable and willing to talk to anyone. Are they talking to the decision makers who have the authority and budget for expenditures? Define and use a filter for the most likely candidates for successful deals. 2. Defining priorities. Prioritize what opportunities they pursue and how much time and effort they spend on them. Help them understand which leads are key opportunities, real and relevant to the current circumstances. 3. Defining time guidelines. Set and enforce guidelines for how sellers spend their time. Meandering aimlessly through a territory or conducting leisurely check-in sweeps is unproductive. Salespeople should be directed to take a strategic and surgical approach to pursuing targets. 4. Monitoring compliance. You need to provide data that allows you and other leaders in the organization to monitor what is happening in the marketplace regarding customers, competitors, and surrounding regulation. Consistency in the execution of a sales process gives data to the organization that clarifies what works and what does not. 5. Navigating the terrain. The sales process is your basis of action, but it's only the start. Use data from it to assess the marketplace. Sometimes you'll need a covert op, a team of select salespeople, to find out new information. Then it's up to you to analyze what they bring back and use that information to up the game. 6. Securing resources. There will be occasions when competing priorities, including those of other departments, derail progress on landing business. Make sure significant opportunities are visible to leadership. You need to take the actions that secure these deals from impeding parties inside your organization. 7. Knowing when and when not to expedite. It's your job to expedite and to know when not to expedite. Like the boy who cried wolf, people may become jaded to repetitive intervention on your part. For the sake of the organization and your reputation, you'll need to know when an opportunity needs to be expedited and when everyone should simply follow the normal sales process. Need help with your sales process? Visit Pipeliner to see how we can help you.